Benton Harbor's public transportation option, Dial-A-Ride, is an on-demand and fixed-route bus service known for its unreliability.
That was my everyday transportation to college and work. It's been around a long time, but it needs to get there faster.
Many of the jobs available to residents are outside the city limits in areas the service doesn't cover. Twin Cities Area Transportation Authority, the operators of Dial-A-Ride, has teamed with University of Michigan researchers to help streamline the system for greater efficiency.
I moved here in 1974. You still had a number of businesses here, a number of factories here, decent jobs, decent income, but then factories started to gradually close. That was really the beginning of the economic demise of Benton Harbor.
Compared to the rest of the state, in Benton Harbor, we have more residents living under the poverty line. These are communities who are income constrained, who have to depend on public transportation. These are people who cannot sort of buy their way out of any negative impacts of transportation investments.
Some folk that's unemployed may not even look for a job outside of the city because transportation is an issue. You can get a job and grow, but if there's no transportation to get you there, then you have to go where the transportation will take you.
Okay, good afternoon, everybody. We're gonna go ahead and get started. I'm gonna talk for 15 minutes or less. Is that okay?
Yes.
All right. So we are a group of faculty, students, and researchers from the University of Michigan. So we wanna know how well the public transportation system provides for your pattern of travel.
This project is called the Benton Harbor Travel Needs Study. We are outreaching to community members directly through this mobility workshop. And what we're looking to do is to understand how are people traveling, how are they getting around, what are the barriers. So we'll have paper surveys, we'll have online surveys. We'll also have a component of the survey that is GPS tracking, which involves individuals either downloading a smartphone application or carrying around a physical GPS tracker. From the data, we expect to learn about the activity patterns of individuals. I think that we have a good opportunity to establish a clear link between public transportation or lack thereof and employment outcomes.
We're very appreciative to University of Michigan for working with us and assisting with doing this study. Part of the outcome that we expect afterward is a design of an app coupled with the installation of tablets in our buses. It's going to enable us to give much better service and to eliminate a lot of the concerns and the complaints people have about waiting.
How long do you usually wait for Dial-A-Ride to get to your house?
How to get people to jobs is a very difficult question. How can we make recommendations for improving the public transportation system in terms of scheduling, in terms of frequency, in terms of routing, that will over time help people to achieve better employment outcomes?